What's going on, guys? It is Bernardo, and today is all about installing ADFS within Windows Server 2022. So let's get right into it. All right, so today is all about installing ADFS, which stands for Active Directory Federation Services within Windows Server 2022. Now, the last time that I actually did this video, I did it 5 years ago. And the reason why I'm doing it is because I'm playing around with Splunk. And within Splunk, you're able to integrate ADFS to do single sign-on. So I needed to build the server within my lab. So this is how I did it. Now, on my desktop, and I'm doing everything within a domain controller. This is like really bad practices. So don't scream at me at the comment section. I just don't have the resources to create multiple machines. So I'm doing everything on this particular machine. Now, I'm going to right click on the start menu. I'm going to click on run. I'm going to type in WinVer and I'm going to hit OK. Now, the reason why I'm doing this is because I want to show you guys that I'm doing it within a Windows Server 2022. On the desktop, we are going to click on the start menu. We are going to locate Windows PowerShell ISE. We're going to right click on it. We're going to go to more. And we're going to select run as an administrator. You're going to get the user account control. So just click on yes. It's going to load up. Now we're going to install the ADFS services or features using PowerShell. Yes, I could go inside the server manager and click next, 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 next and do all that stuff. But within PowerShell, you're able to run one command and that is this. That's it. That's all you have to do. We're going to run it. It's going to start collecting data. It's going to start installing and it's done. You don't need to do a restart at all. Done. Now, on the desktop, we are going to click on the start menu. And within the start menu, we are going to locate and click on Server Manager. So click on it. It's going to load up. On the upper right-hand side, you're going to see that flag. And right next to the flag, you're going to see an exclamation point, like a warning. We're going to click on that. And it wants you to do a pulse deployment configuration for the Federation service that we just installed. So where it says configure the Federation service on the server, that right there is a hyperlink. So let's click on it. It's going to load up the wizard. Click on next. Once it finished loading up, it takes you here. I'm going to leave it as the default. You are able to specify an account, but I left it as a default because I was just trying to do everything pretty fast. And as soon as you click next, bingo, you have to have an SSL certificate. Now, again, like I said before, I did this 5 years ago. I found the email that I actually purchased the SSL for that ADSF server that I built for you guys, or actually did the video for you guys 5 years ago. I'm not going to do that on this video. I'm going to actually build a certificate authority server. And I'm going to do it right now with you guys. So let's head back inside the wizard. Let's cancel this. Let's click on yes to cancel it. And then within here, we're going to click on manage. We're going to select add roles and features. We're going to click next, next again, next again. And we're going to locate the Active Directory certificate services. We're going to give it a check mark. We're going to click add features because we want all the features. We're going to click next here. We're going to click next here. Make sure certification authority is checked off. Click next. A nice little confirmation. Click install. It's going to start installing the features. And once it's done, you're going to get this. This is good. Where it says configure Active Directory certificate services on the destination server, that is a hyperlink. So let's click on it. It's going to start the wizard. I'm going to leave the credentials as is. You are able to change it. It is up to you. I'm going to click next here. For the services, we want certification authority. So check it off. Great. Let's click next. I'm going to leave it as an enterprise CA. So click next. I'm going to leave it as a root CA. Click next here. I'm definitely going to create a new private key. So click next. For the cryptographic options, I left it as a default, but you are able to change it as well as increase the key length. But because I left it as default, I'm going to click on next. The CA name, I'm going to leave it as this. Click next here. For the period, typically 5 years is standard. You are able to increase it. I think Microsoft recommends 5 to 10 years. I left it as 5 years, and I'm going to click next. For the database location, you are able to change it, but I left it as the default, so click next here. A nice little confirmation, and then click on configure. It's going to start configuring itself, and then eventually you're going to get this, a green check mark, configuration succeeded, which is great. Let's close this. Let's close this. And on the upper right-hand side, let's click on tools. Let's locate the certification authority, so click on it. Going to load up. Double-click on the certification authority server name, right? The common name. So double-click on that to open it up. We're going to select the certificate templates. We're going to right-click on that folder. We're going to click on manage. Within here, we're going to locate web server. We're going to right-click on the web server template. We're going to duplicate the template. Within here, let's go to general. Give your template a display name. I gave it the following. Let's head over to the security tab. And within the security tab, make sure that authenticated users is selected. And underneath, make sure that you have enroll to allow. Just give it a check mark. Click on apply. Click OK. Let's close out of here. Once you close out of that, it's going to take you here. We're going to right-click on the certificate templates folder. We're going to click on new, and we're going to select certificate template to issue. Locate the new template that we created. For me, was SSL certificates. So click OK. There it goes. Awesome. So we're going to right-click on the start menu. We're going to go to run. We're going to type in MMC. We're going to click OK. You're going to get the user account control for the Microsoft Management Console. So just click yes here. It's going to load up. We're going to click on file. We're going to click on add remove snap-in. And we're going to locate certificates and click on add to move it over to your right. As soon as you do that, you're going to get, you know, certificate snap-in. You know, what do you want to manage? We want to manage computer account. So click next. It is going to be the local computer. And we're going to click finish and click OK. So from here, we're going to open up the certificates node, and we're going to right click on the personal folder, and we're going to go to all tasks, and we're going to select request a new certificate because we are requesting a certificate for our Active Directory Federation Services server. Within all tasks, we are going to select request a new certificate. It's going to load up the wizard. From here, we're going to click on next. We're going to click next here. And we need to locate our certificate or our template that we created. But underneath our certificate, it wants more information. So where it says more information is required to enroll for the certificate, click here to configure settings. Click on that because we need to add additional properties for the certificate. Now, for the subject name, the type, we're going to change it to common name. And you're going to provide the full qualified domain name of your server. Now, yes, DC02 is not the best name for this. Most likely, I would recommend, you know, naming it as ADFS dot whatever your domain is, like I did 5 years ago, the correct way. But again, I'm very limited with resources, so I'm using this for now. As soon as you provide the value, click on add to move it to the right. Now, for the alternative name, the type, we're going to click on the dropdown, and we're going to select DNS. Now, the values that I entered and added to the right would be the following. I added the full qualified domain name of the server as well as adfs.mydomain. And I also created a record pointing to that particular DNS and pointing to the domain controller's IP address. Now, from my research and from my understanding, you also need to add the DNS of enterprise registration dot whatever is your domain. And make sure you have an A record pointing to the correct IP address of your server. Once you do all that, we're going to click apply. We're going to click OK. We're going to select our certificate. So give it a check mark and then click on enroll. It's going to start enrolling. Give it some time and then green check mark succeeded. Great. So click on finish. Now from here, we're going to open up the personal folder. We're going to go into certificates and there goes our certificate that we just, you know, requested. The way that you know that it is the certificate that you requested, right in the column where it says certificate templates, is going to say the name that you provided the certificate, that, you know, the template that we created. For me, I called it SSL certificates. Whatever you gave it, it's going to be there. Now, let's close this up. Let's head back into our server manager. And on the upper right-hand side, where that little flag that has a little warning, we're going to click on it. We're going to click on configure the Federation service on this server. Click on it to start the wizard again. We're going to click next here. I left it as the default. Click next. Now, if I click on the dropdown, I have a certificate.
Yes.
So click on the certificate. Make sure you pick the right one. I feel like best practice is to actually purchase a certificate with the full qualified domain name of your server and just import it. But I'm doing everything locally. I don't want to purchase a SSL certificate for this because I'm just testing out Splunk and single sign-on. So I'm doing it this way. For the display name, I gave it the following. I'm going to click next. Now, this is common. 5 years ago, this actually happened to me. And the way that we fixed it is running a PowerShell command. So we're going to head over to Windows PowerShell ISE because I already had it open when I ran this command with you guys. And we're going to run the following one-liner. So we're going to run it. Great. Let's head back into the wizard. We're going to click on previous and then click on next, and the banner is gone. Now, that actually allows us to create a group managed service account. So give it a check mark to create one, and then give it a name. I give it this, pretty self-explanatory, right? Click next here. For the database, I left it as the default. I'm going to have a Windows internal database. If you do have an SQL server, pick that and then point to it. Let's click next. A nice little review, click next. The pre-check passed. I got one warning, which is okay. Let's click on configure. It's going to validate the SSL certificate. It's going to process and done. Configuration is done. So let's close that up. Great. Next thing that we need to do is reboot the server. I rebooted my server and my server is actually located within my Proxmox lab. So this is why I'm showing you right here. This is DC02 and it's being rebooted. Once it reboots, log into your server. Get into the desktop, load up PowerShell or PowerShell ISE, and we need to run the following command. Run this command. Once you run it, nothing happens. Now, the reason why we need to run this is because the next thing that we're going to do is open up your favorite browser. I opened up Microsoft Edge, and we're going to go into the following URL. We're going to hit enter. It's going to load this up. Now, if you don't run that PowerShell command first and you hit sign in, it's going to error out. It's not going to work. So now if I hit sign in and I put my information and I click on sign in, you should get this. You are signed in. This is great. If you do not run that PowerShell command first, you're not going to get this. So run that PowerShell command first. Now, another thing that you want to check is your event logs. If you open up the event viewer within your server and you go into custom views, server roles, Active Directory, Federation services, and you want to locate the event ID 100. 100 basically tells you that all the services are running and it gives you like a crap load of URLs that are, you know, not useless, but they're useful. But this right here, this event log right here, event ID tells you that your services are up and running. Another way to test and validate that your ADFS is up and running properly: locate a machine within your network. I went into my PC02 and I open up a browser. And within the browser, I typed in the following URL and I'm going to hit enter. As soon as you hit enter, you're going to get your connection is in private. So just click on advanced and just click on continue to whatever. For me, it was adfs.btnhd.edu. So click on that and it should load up this XML gibberish. If it loads up this, this is a good sign. That means your ADFS was configured properly. If it doesn't and it provides errors, it is time to start Googling and researching and troubleshooting to see what's going on. That's it. Hopefully you guys enjoyed this video and I catch you guys on the next one. Peace out.